Welcome to AP Environmental Science. In this video, we are going to talk a little bit about how hydrogen fuel cells work and the benefits and drawbacks of using them as an energy source. First of all, what is a hydrogen fuel cell? Well, this is similar to a battery, and both a battery and a hydrogen fuel cell are going to use chemicals to generate energy. Now remember, laws of thermodynamics, we're not creating new energy, we're just converting energy. Now, in a conventional battery, you have a set amount of those inputs or the components to generate that energy. Whereas in a hydrogen fuel cell, this is an open loop. So you're putting hydrogen fuel into a tank, and that tank then fuels the hydrogen cell battery. Now, hydrogen fuel cells, because we have this constant flow in of energy, they do not need to be recharged. You just need to refill your hydrogen tank when things start running low. So this makes them a little different than, say, an electric battery vehicle. So how do we go from hydrogen fuel into actual energy? Well, this happens in two steps. We really start with that hydrogen fuel being added to the cell or a gas tank, so to speak. And that hydrogen fuel could be a liquid or a gas. And then the process involves two steps. In the first step, that hydrogen molecule is split into protons and electrons. Now, these protons and electrons take different paths through the actual fuel cell. The protons are going to move across a membrane, whereas the electrons are going to follow a wire, and that is going to carry that electric current. Now, that electric current is then going to go to, say, an electric motor to make a car move. Now, in step two, those hydrogen ions need to have something happen to them. So oxygen from the atmosphere is going to be split and join in with those protons, and that creates water vapor. Now, the only emission coming out the tailpipe of a hydrogen fuel cell vehicle would be water vapor. So I want to take a little closer look here at the layout or schematic of a fuel cell vehicle. Now, this is a direct alternative to conventional gasoline or diesel powered vehicles. Typically, you'll see this on the scale of, say, a city bus running on hydrogen fuel cell, because those are types of vehicles that are not very easily converted to, say, an electric battery vehicle, just because of the size and the amount of power needed. So with a fuel cell vehicle, you have your hydrogen tank that then goes into the fuel cell where those two steps of reactions that we just discussed take place. And that current from the reaction then goes to the electric motor, which causes the wheels to turn. But how do we get hydrogen? Now, hydrogen does exist in nature, but it's not extremely common. So we have to do two different processes in order to extract that. The first type of process that can be used is called electrolysis. And this is using an electric current to split water into hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. This is really the opposite of what is happening in a hydrogen fuel cell. The other way that hydrogen can be obtained to be put into these gas containers, so to speak, for a fuel cell vehicle would be from natural gas. Now, natural gas would be considered a fossil fuel. And in order to extract this, we are splitting methane using heat. And in the process, we are producing carbon dioxide. So we are still producing greenhouse gases if we are getting our hydrogen from natural gas. Now, keep in mind, both of these processes to obtain hydrogen require the use of energy. So this is going to decrease that net energy production from using hydrogen as a fuel source. Remember, gross production is the total amount of energy produced using that hydrogen, but then net would be subtracting out the amount of energy needed to create that gross energy production. Kind of like gross primary productivity and net primary productivity and how we had to account for respiration in that equation. Now, there are several benefits to using hydrogen fuel cells. They have a relatively small environmental impact, especially compared to conventional gasoline and diesel vehicles. And most of the impacts of using hydrogen fuel vehicles is actually from the process of obtaining that hydrogen. Also, there's no carbon dioxide emissions from the vehicle itself. And using an electric engine is actually much more efficient than using an internal combustion engine. So you're able to go further on that single charge or that single fuel cell. Again, there are drawbacks, just like there are with any energy source. Hydrogen gas is explosive, and it's not very common in nature, so we have to make that artificially. And of course, it takes energy in order to make that hydrogen. And if we are using methane, that methane is not a clean energy source, that's a fossil fuel, and we're releasing carbon dioxide in that process. Also, the technology required to develop and scale up hydrogen fuel cell vehicles to be widespread is extremely expensive. So that's another hurdle to overcome. Now, in summary, you should be able to describe in general how a hydrogen fuel cell works, be able to describe the process used to create hydrogen for use in a fuel cell. So a general overview of what electrolysis is and how it's extracted from natural gas. Again, you do not need to know the nitty-gritty of each of those processes, just an overall idea of what they are. And of course, you need to be able to describe the benefits and drawbacks of using hydrogen fuel cells as an energy source. Please leave me your questions here at the end, and I hope that as you watch this video, you were able to learn something.